What's going on, everybody? So today I'm going to be doing my version of a smoked Kalua pork. That's right, basically going a little bit Hawaiian on this one. I've actually, for the first time in my life, obtained some banana leaves to actually wrap this up in. This should be an interesting cook. I'm going to actually show you some of the tips and tricks that I use along the way in this process of this pork shoulder, making it more of a Hawaiian type style flavor. And like I said, I'm also going to be adding in some layers so you can see how I set up my smoker for tonight, as well as prepping the pork shoulder for an awesome cook. So without further ado, let's get into it and let's have some fun.
You ready? Let's go!
First, I'm taking a little bit of this double smoke from my man Adam McKenzie. Throw that in there. Alright, as you can see, I got that mixed up pretty good. Next, I'm going to take some of this mango nectar. I'm going to pour that in there. And then I'm also going to pour in this pineapple juice. Obviously, I think this is going to give it that Hawaiian kind of flavor, if you will. Mix this together, and then basically I'm going to use this as the injection that's going to go inside this pork. First things first, had a nice little pork shoulder on sale, and basically when I'm trying to find a nice good pork shoulder, it's bone in usually, and it has good marbling to it. That's one of the things I really like. As far as trimming fat, I don't do a whole lot of trimming. There'll be a little bit here that I'm going to do, but quite frankly, that's kind of the beauty about pork shoulders, just leaving a lot of the fat on there just so it can render down. Obviously makes that tender and juicy as it cooks. So yeah, there's a few pieces on here just not particularly care for, but other than that, I'm gonna leave it the way it is, and we're basically gonna get into the next step. Part of this process, if you will, for a normal Kalua pork would be kind of dry brining it with Hawaiian salt, pink salt. I don't have no Hawaiian pink salt, so I'm gonna do this the way I normally would be, which is basically seasoning this up. But first, we just made that injection, so what I'm gonna do is get my injection in here. Oh, and then basically go into the shoulder. I try to do this from the side. It's kind of hard to handle, so I'll do the best I can to show you how I do this. Going into the pork shoulder, and then of course as I'm injecting, I'm also pulling out, and I just keep pulling out. You can see what that does is just going to get the injection spread throughout the pork shoulder completely. I'm sure it helps if I can move my hand for you so you can kind of see. And I'm just basically going to do that in a couple of spots here, just to get that injection and that flavor in there. Basically it's got that mango in there, as well as the pineapple juice, and like I said, it's got that double smoke, which really has a nice kind of barbecue flavor. So get this one injected down here. You can see where the meat's kind of blowing up a little bit. I can feel it on this side, obviously. Whoops, a little overflow there. Alright, now I'm going to take one injection straight down the middle here, and then we should be good. I don't have a whole lot of injection left. Obviously, if you want to inject more, you can. This is about the amount that I would normally do, so I'm not going to go completely crazy with this. One of the keys I'm getting ready to show you what I do, besides this, is I'm going to next score the fat on the fat side, and then I'm also going to be basically wrapping this in saran wrap overnight after I season it. So next, I'm basically going to score this fat in kind of a crosshatch kind of manner. Everybody's probably seen this multiple times. If you've ever watched any barbecue videos, they're pretty much, they all, a lot of times will do this. And essentially the reason I like to do this is because it's going to help that fat kind of render a little bit more, but also as I'm doing this, I'm creating pockets, if you will, for the seasoning to get in there. So, all right, again, I'm using that double smoke from my man Adam McKenzie, this Juke and Q. If you haven't checked him out, by all means, go do so. He's got an awesome channel too. Does a lot of good stuff. Just a good guy in general. All right, now that I've got that seasoned up really good, got this side now. I'm just gonna cover this pork as much as I can with the seasoning all over. Like I said, normally a Hawaiian pink salt would be used to brine this, kind of dry brine this, from what I understand, but to be honest with you, I'm not a real big salt man. Just not. I'm not saying it doesn't work. In fact, I just recently got a Himalayan salt block that I've been testing out. But I'm just not like big into salt for dry brining purposes. It's just, to me, I don't know. It doesn't really seem to add the kind of flavor, quality flavors that I'm looking for, especially when it comes to barbecue. For me, barbecue is barbecue, and this is the kind of seasoning I would want to have on my barbecue. So, the other little trick that I'm gonna do, and this is what I do with pretty much all my pork shoulders, I always try to do these typically the day before. This is a little bit earlier in the afternoon. I won't be cooking until this evening, or start to cook until this evening. But with that being said, wrapping this up will allow these flavors to seal in, as well as, you know, hold that injection into the meat. It seems to work for me. I've done it multiple times, and I'm a big believer. If you can wrap your pork, and this works for spare ribs or baby backs too, if you ever have the time, it just helps seal in that flavor a little bit more. This is kind of like a, I guess you could say, my version of brining something, in a sense. It's gonna, that juice is gonna just basically sit inside of there, and then of course the seasoning itself is gonna keep that locked in. So yeah, this should be good. Definitely looking forward to seeing how this turns out. A little bit more to go. Looking forward to trying the banana leaves as opposed to the paper and the foil, which I've used in the past. So I am definitely curious to see which one's better at the end. So, little nighttime cook going with basically a pork shoulder. We're gonna cook Kalua style, Hawaiian style, if you will. You can see this is how I start the prime 6 charcoal. Basically get it centered. The trick is, I usually like to put in some wood chunks in there. I basically get some apple, and then of course I got, you know, some previously used charcoal there. And then what I'm just gonna basically do is put that charcoal there on top, as you can see it. And essentially as that catches, then I'll spread that amongst the other bricks of coal. And then essentially we'll get that ready to roll. Certainly excited to see how this turns out. It'll be the first time I've ever used a banana leaf to wrap pork when it's all said and done. But like I said, this should be a good one. So stay tuned. As you can see, prime 6 charcoal rolling hot. So now basically what I'm going to do, you can kind of see the center is already ignited. I'm going to take some of these blocks that are basically brand new, replace them with these that are already lit, and that'll help get this fire kind of consistently going across all of this. And that should give us a good even cook. We'll get the pork on here in just a minute, and I'll show you what that looks like. All right, as you can see, I have the pan on there. Now, basically, I'm putting my rack extender in place. This will allow me to basically heat up this water pan that has mostly water, a little bit of pineapple and juice in there, to keep the pork moist while it's cooking. As you know, heat always really rises to the top. It's one of the reasons I like this rack extender, besides the fact that I can put it in this water pan. It's a barrier, and it works out great. It's time to get the pork butt on there. I'm gonna go fat side down, just because I want the bark to form on this. And I think it's gonna work out. You can see the color on that. It looks pretty amazing already. As you can see, the pork butt's on there. Color looks deep and rich already. The process with this will be, I want to get as much bark on this as possibly, probably 3 to 4 hours into this. Then I'm going to wrap it in those banana leaves, which I've never done before. And then I'm going to use another concoction inside of that wrap to keep this thing moist while it finishes out the cook. So we'll see how it goes. Definitely curious to see how it turns out. Should be a good one. Let's stay tuned and we'll see how it goes. All right, I got that temperature probe set in there. Once this hits a temperature between 165, 168, that's when I'm going to obviously wrap this up. Like I said, I got the water pan down here below with mostly water, a little bit of pineapple juice. Prime 6 charcoal is rolling hot. I'm not going to have to worry about this the rest of the night. I'm going to close up this Kamado, get it set where it needs to be as far as the settings. We should be good. That pork looks amazing. Right now it's at a seeing an internal temp of 165, so I'm going to get this pulled off, get it wrapped up in that banana leaf, and then get it back on the cooker, and then we'll wrap this up. Man, I tell you what though, this looks great already. Certainly excited to see how this turns out. Should be good. Basically doing a cross section with it. One this way, one this way, and one this way. Basically using the weight of the pork butt to hold it in there. And I'm just gonna simply tie this off. And as I tie it off, that'll keep it all together. We'll get it on the cooker. All right, get that wrapped up. I've also got it into this pan. The leaf itself is semi-strong, but I don't necessarily trust it, so I'm just gonna keep it in that pan while it's wrapped up in that. I'm also gonna put in just a little bit of that mango juice as well. All right, have some. We'll get this into the cooker around 300. We'll see how it turns out. All right, we hit the 204 mark. As you can see, definitely pro tender. So I'm gonna let this rest inside the Cambro for about an hour or so, and then we'll pull it apart. Here it is, time to show you what this Kalua pork looks like. I am definitely excited to see how it turned out. So without further ado, let's get into it and let's see what this looks like. All right, first things first, let's get it out of the Cambro. Look at all that steam come out. It's actually kind of cold out today, believe it or not. Go figure, in May, Memorial weekend, and it's cold outside. So hopefully you can see this. Yeah. Put a little temple on this just so it wouldn't get messed up. You need to get a scissors. Alright, moment of truth. I've never used a banana leaf in my life to wrap pork. Always first time for everything. You can see it's kind of getting brittle. Moist in parts, obviously. Kind of like a, obviously, butcher paper would be. Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. The color on this is absolutely phenomenal. This looks incredible. And you can just smell the aroma of the barbecue. Oh, this is gonna be great. Let me get this turned around so you can get a better look at it. And then we'll go from there. I'm gonna get this banana leaf off of here as much as I can. You don't need that in there. All right. So man, I tell you what, this pork seriously smells amazing. All right, time for the moment of truth. There you go, look at that. Clean bone pull. You can't ask for anything better than that when it comes to pork. Oh my gosh. Major flavor. Here's a little trick. You can use the bone to break down your pork. Seen somebody doing this the other day. I thought, hey, that's a cool idea. So look at this. I'm gonna bring this up closer so you can see it. Look Look at this pork. Look at the smoke ring on that pork. Just absolutely ridiculous. I'm telling you, there's something about this banana leaf process that seems to work. I think I could still get comparable flavors with the paper, but man, very tender, absolutely juicy on the inside. Yeah, just look at that pink, beautiful smoke ring, excellent bark. Flavor is outstanding. Cannot wait to serve this up today. Have family coming over. Definitely looking forward to seeing what their thoughts on this as well. It's gonna be good.
Definitely an awesome meal. As you can see, that pork turned out magnificent. One of my favorite pork shoulders to date. The flavors came through in every which way. Using that pineapple juice, the mango juice, everything, including the seasoning, just went great with this. The amount of, you know, apple wood that we had in there and the amount of charcoal just gave this thing an excellent bark. It's juicy, absolutely tender on the inside, as you've seen. The smoke ring was excellent. It was just such a wonderful cook. So until next time, good cooking. And like I said, hopefully you'll try this out. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also, don't forget about those notifications, and I can't wait to see you again.